Every time I come to work now and I see this blue door, I just get this like thrill of excitement. So today is a good day. As usual, I'm the first one down here. I like to have a little bit of quiet time. Well, just me and the heater, right? but if you can imagine all four DeMarcos in here, it's been pretty wonderful. There's Max's station. There's Faith's station. Mine. Brianne's. And then I know I've showed you guys this before, right? This is the map of all the places that we've filmed in Washington. And we have filmed one spot or one or two spots in Arizona and two or three spots in Oregon. We're thinking of what we should do that way. But it's a photograph of Brianne that I had mounted. But look what's out here, you guys. Isn't that wonderful? Got a bit of snow last night. And there's the craft services hot drink station. We have these little old-fashioned type little candy jars on each of the desks and over here, and that's in honor of my mom. And 1976 to 1977, she ran a little old-time candy shop with penny and nickel candies, you know, like you could come in and buy singles, and that's me with her. So we wanted that little homage to her. And then over here, these are pictures of me in a little side table with my dad's parents. And that is the little table that is now over here by my desk. So, I don't want anyone to ever forget that this is a family business, you know, even as we grow. It's Brianne's trophies displayed proudly. All the different teams she's been on. Here's out the orchard. There's the platform that will become the yellow door studio. Red door studio is right over there. Green door studio is behind the red door. And then pink door is if you go that way. So, but yeah, pretty amazing. Can't wait to get our new shipment of more DVDs, because you guys know we've got like 12 new ones. I still haven't been able to make the time to go through this first batch of props, but it's on the schedule. And here is our, what we call the vlogging room, but that's because it has this big, beautiful blue backdrop. And these are soft lights that at night, it just makes the most phenomenal place to vlog. The lighting is so gorgeous. It's like it's like filming someone in front of a fireplace, which I always thought would be really tricky. And then I found out it was really easy and really beautiful. But this room, we usually have the table and chairs not set up, but we had a workshop here. People were plugged in with their computers. So right now we have the table set up. And the big white cabinet has come down. So now all of the furniture and everything that made up the office upstairs is now down here. That's all full of scripts. That I feel also needs to be organized. But the good news is that I was able to come to work this morning and be awake enough to not set off the alarm or the cameras on myself. So that was kind of a good thing. I've only done that one day so far, but once was enough. And they warn you about the decibel of the alarms for a reason. You know, they say if you're going to test them, put like a blanket or a towel over the speaker of the alarm. It's like, wow. I mean, it was drop to your knees type of loud. So that was pretty amazing. And in terms of the cameras, I mean, I don't care if it records me for a while, it's fine. But it's just like, it doesn't need to be on when we're in here. So they only get snapped on then when we go. So anyway, I think I'll get to work now. Well,
It's about 2 o'clock and it's the end of another work day. We went into 2018 saying that we were gonna only work a 6-day work week, but that didn't actually wind up happening for a number of different reasons. I think that it was actually in direct conflict with our goal this year to reach the end of this year with no backlog and no projects that we are contractually obligated to do, so that we are then moving into 2019 with only passion projects. So what that means is that, you know, we ran a franchise called the Take 8 Film Festival, and there were 4 incarnations of that. And what really wound up happening, actually from the very beginning, but it just, issues kind of compounded over time, is that we found that even if a project won or gained a lot of notoriety or popularity during the making of the festival, it wasn't always that team that most deserved and most wanted, had that fire in the belly to turn their short film entry into a feature film. And so sometimes we did find that we felt our hands were a little bit tied, because just like with our Forge Flashpoints and the Take 8 Film Festivals and all of our film anthology events, we truly let the audience decide the winners. So there isn't like a panel of buddies that get together for dinner and everyone is best friends and everyone's submitting to each other's little festivals, and then the same panel of little buddies is choosing the winners. This is truly audience choice. And the audiences, of course, aren't there with you when you're on set, and they don't see how passionately some of the teams are about making their story and working with Blue Forge. And so we realized that that isn't something that we wanted to continue, which is had a lot to do with why we ended the Forge Flashpoint series after 5 installments, and why we ended the Take 8 Film Festival franchise after 4 installments. And we're really happy with those decisions. This doesn't mean that we don't like the films that won, certainly not. In almost every case, I write all of the short films for the Take 8 Film Festival franchise. So, I mean, I've never in my life written something that I don't feel connected to in some way. But it was just, it was about that fire in the belly. It really came down to that. And there are folks that we cast regularly that are all over the spectrum in terms of economics, age, size, race, political views, that we consider part of our familial familial troupe. So we want to continue to work with those guys, and we want to have the freedom to be able to do that. So because we want to go into 2019 with just passion projects that we're focusing on, we knew that 2018 was going to be a bit of a mishmash. It was going to have some projects that we are contractually obligated to create. So obviously we're going to pour our heart and soul into those, because we want to make them worth every moment that we are on set. And then also some passion projects, Gentleman Longlegs Season 2, Teatro de Freaks Season 3, Brienne's Alex in Wonderland, Maxwell's Corner of Chaos. So we have a real mix this year, but because we do have that mix and we do have that backlog of getting all of our previous projects out commercially, because, you know, we were releasing them on a limited scale, you know, on the YouTube channel or in red carpet premieres locally at local cinemas, and we knew that we needed to keep our revenue stream strong. And remember, the vast majority of our revenue comes from the sales and rentals of our commercial work, so we needed to make sure that more of our work was out there for a commercial audience. So because of that, the backlog, the contractually obligated stuff, and the passion projects, this is going to be a very full year. So we realized that we were going to have to continue to pull 7-day work weeks the way we did in 2017. But you know, we are still self-employed, so that means we do have some freedom. You know, we can bounce things around, and we can work extra long shifts on one day if we take another day off and things like that. But today was a really good day. I got to do the editing and the scoring for Gentleman Longlegs Season 2, Episode 0, which is kind of a sneak peek into the rest of the season that we'll start posting in November of 2018. That's our animated series about those little spiders. And I also got to send two commercial DVDs to the manufacturer. And that's a process of, we call it producing. It's the final producing. So I get to be a producer today. That's basically where you take a day to create, gather up all your materials, all your bonus features, all of your content, whether it's a film or single episodes, make sure that you have all of the right stuff and your bonus features. And then you lay it all out in the program and you decide which bonus features come in what order, what thumbnails for each of the bonus features and the main feature. You design your menu music and your menus. And then you render it twice. You render it as a disc copy and you actually burn it onto a DVD, which is kind of like our in-house proofing stage, which saves us about $28 a project, which, as you guys know, as a micro-budget studio, that means the world to us. As a matter of fact, we can feed the four of us for $28 for 2 or 3 days, actually, in a pinch. So, proofing in-house is important. And then I also burn it as a digital copy, an ISO file, which is what gets sent to the manufacturer. And then once those things are done, and they can't really be rushed because it takes a really long time to both burn an HD DVD and burn the ISO file, but it's very stable. The machine that I work on is very, very stable, so I have never experienced like a crash or an error in the rendering process. Then I upload to the manufacturer and I walk through their process. I choose what distribution channels I want for this project with them. I assign things like, if it's a book, I assign like the BISAC code and stuff like that. And then it's also checked on their end. Now, the their end check is supposed to take 10 business days. And it always does not take 10 business days. I try to explain this to our partners and tell them to get things in early, but for some reason they think I'm making it up, or 10 business days is what they keep in their heads. So at 10 business days, I have never heard back from the manufacturer. And so then I contact them and I say, hi, status update. It always goes down the exact same way. Within 24 hours, they write me back and thank me for my message and say that they're researching it. Within 48 hours, from that first 24 hours, so now it's been 3 days. They then tell me that further research is needed and they'll be talking to the direct representative in charge of this specific project. And it's a new rep at the manufacturer every single project, even if two projects are uploaded on the same day. Then, within 3 days of that, so now we're almost at an additional week, what we're at like 6 days now, right? I hear back that the file has now been approved. So it's like, the squeaky wheel gets the grease. It's like that theory of doing business. And this frustrates me. As a Virgo, it frustrates me, but it is the process. And then it is done. They then say, okay, it's good to go. And we've already proved it in-house, so we don't need to, often, sometimes, if we're afraid something has gone wrong on their end, we do then ask them to send us a proof. But like I said, that costs between $26 and $28, so we try to avoid that. And then it takes an additional 2 to 3 weeks for the DVD to then appear with online vendors and such and so like that. I don't know if you guys have met Chester before. He's, hey Chester boy. He's the only boy dog in the house. He's a golden Schaberke. But I don't know if you guys can actually see him. I don't know how I'm exactly framed, but anyway, he's a good boy. Some of my job is a lot of hurry up and wait. You know, I try to rush things kind of into this bottleneck, and then at the manufacturer bottlenecks, and then it opens up again. And people are always like, wow, it takes so long. I'm like, wow, boy, you've never really worked with a large studio before, have you? Or a large publishing house before? Because we're like lightning freaking fast. But, you know, hey, it's okay. I know that we all come from our own life experience. And all I can do is just continue to speak to the truth that is in front of me at my screen or whatever it is. So that was today, so I did those two. And then the other thing is that I had to work out the schedules for the short film featurette that we're doing, Trade, which that's one of those contractual obligations, but at the same time, I did wind up feeling incredibly passionate about the project. That was the winner of the SparkForge Film Festival, was an ultra short, a one-page film, turned out to be like a minute long, called Tradewind, and Jackson Robert Harm was the writer of that script, and it won the SparkForge Film Festival, and we made it into a featurette. And so that's going to be filmed. I needed to work out scheduling for that. Teatro Season 3 has some scenes that I really want to film at a particular location at this time of year. So that those scripts, which haven't even been written yet, and I'm hoping my next vlog, I'm going to open it by telling you guys all 8 scripts for Teatro Season 3 are done. That hopefully will be the next thing that I vlog about. But so I have to write those. But I had to do some scheduling for that. So I had to schedule even though the scripts aren't even done yet, because this location at this time of year is exactly what we need. And then Brianna and I had to have a bit of a budgeting meeting about the beginning of the year budget. And then, which we always do toward the end of February, beginning of March, because January and February, there literally is no money. Like literally, there is no money. And there is never bleed from the previous year, in this case 2017. We have done savings accounts and stuff like that to try to carry us through Januarys and Februarys, because see, this is all what comes down to that ultimately, you know, we run a retail business and all of our vendors pay on 90 or 120 days out. So we don't see Christmas money until March or April or May, you know, Christmas sales. So it's like, it can get really, really screwy. And I don't have a big enough ego or hubris to not share, like for instance, our friends, Amber and Eric, who work with us in several of the divisions of the company, were literally like bringing us hot dinners just to make sure the kids weren't eating like ramen and cereal, all of January and February. I mean, you know, this is, we're not starving and we are paying our bills, but I'm talking about our absolute mandatory bills. So when folks say, oh my gosh, I want to grow up to be just like you. And I'm like, no, not the kids. The kids don't say that. Don't worry. I think that would be so horrible for me. I'm like, no, I want you to strive for more. I want you to strive for more than mama. But when we meet other filmmakers, especially our authors, I want to be just like you. And I'm like, no, strive to be even better. Because, you know, if we made more commercial type choices, if we took more commercial side work, we wouldn't have a slow January and February, because there's a lot of stuff. If we were willing to, you know, do more camera for hire start stuff, and if I was willing to still write scripts for pay, that would take care. It's just, I think we, over these past 6 years, we've gotten to this place where the kids are old enough, they have a say in the business now, we can start to make these decisions together, the four of us, and we're like, look, we're not suffering. Yeah, it's hard at the beginning of the year, but we're not suffering. You know, we have a home, and we have vehicles, and we have food, and we choose to have lots of animals, and we choose to be at home with the kids, and we choose to run this business, and we choose to all be together. So to us, it's worth it. But what I'm hoping, and I think the other reason, actually, I have to circle back around. The other reason that working a 7-day work week, staying through 2018, also wound up being okay. And I know I talked to you guys about this in a vlog in the past, but you know, we have dinners together now at our dining room table. And all of the work accoutrements, the cabinets, the desks, the computers are all out of the dining room. And we do actually have a dining room. We not only have a dining room, but we have a dining room that we broke through the wall several years ago and added a beautiful picture window. and where there was no window at all. So, I mean, like, we have this beautiful dining room, and now we are using it. And I am very proud to say that since we moved into the new space at the top of February, from February 1st on, we have had every single day a dinner together as a family at that dining room table. That was my dining room table when I was growing up. It's the Thomasville Pine dining room table that I have loved. And can you covet something if it is yours? But that just, I don't know, it has so many good memories of me doing homework there and having dinner with my family, and I love it, and it fits us perfectly. So it's funny, that might seem like a little thing, and sometimes dinner is a little thing, but that makes it worth it. And of course, like I showed you guys today at the first half of this vlog, all four of us working right literally together, that's also, it's changed everything. So I don't miss it. So again, my next vlog, I hope to be telling you guys about a whole bunch of writing that has been done. I did wind up writing that featurette trade. It wound up being 174 shots. I think that's correct. It wound up being 174 shots. The way I write, 6 shots is roughly a minute. And I did it in 8 hours, but spread out over 3 days, 8 hours spread out over 3 days. I had really hoped to just sit down and do it all in one day, but life kept getting in the way. So, you know, messages are going off and people are freaking out and people want to have part in a project, but the project's deadline's already passed, or somebody missed the deadline, or, you know, those are the kind of stuff that as CEO, that's what I'm supposed to deal with. That's part of what I deal with, is the managing of the people. And we also had the gaming workshop during that time, which was amazing to get together both gamers and writers and teach them how to make the incredible Blueforge Gaming Adventure Deck 2.0 decks. And that was really inspiring. Oh my gosh. So, but I am hoping the next time that I talk with you guys, I will have written Teatro de Freak Season 3, and maybe also Season 1 of K-Girl, KGRL. Well, I'll tell you guys more about that one next time. Thanks, you guys. Bye.